Very funny. It's, glad I'm out and warming up here at the ice rink at Herbert Buena Center. Kurt Browning, four-time world champion, figure skater. Kurt, hey, thanks for being with us. You're lacing up. You know, a lot of you're such a great skater, people don't know what you do before you skate. And you were doing this. He was doing this. He was like stomping. Why were you stomping?
It's a secret. Don't tell everybody, but everyone knows. You stomp your feet, get the blood going.
Okay.
Gets the energy out.
You know, when you're here in the ice rink looking at people, in your competition, do you ever do that pro athlete boxing thing where you just, you know, stare them down?
In figure skating?
Yeah.
No, it's more like we just look at each other going, you're wearing that. You're going down. I don't know. Figure skating it's not very combative, but you can psych yourself out more than you can your opponent.
Well, this is the man who claims he could improvise to any song, and we're going to put you to the test. Yes, we picked some good songs.
But we're going to try it.
We're going to do like, he's lacing up, so he'll be out there when we come back to Mornings on 2.
We're going to improv. Ah!
Francisco, isn't it interesting, Mark, being a stand-up comic like you are?
Yes.
Gore is so relaxed in those kinds of situations, then he starts talking politics, and it's like watching, you know, paint dry.
I don't understand that. I mean, when I'm on stage and off stage, I'm the same person.
Yeah.
All right.
Crazy.
I got world championship figure skaters here. We met Kurt Browning earlier. This is Lucinda Roux. Lucinda, thanks for being with us.
Thank you.
Lucinda, and Kurt will attest to this, best spinner in the world?
Best spinner in the world, right here.
And the best person in the world, so that's for sure.
270 spins per minute, is that correct?
Yes.
Who counted?
It was actually just a team of us. A group of people got together and taped it.
Okay, you're going to do it for us now, though.
All right, I'll
try. You're never going to see this. This is they're getting ready for the Target Stars on Ice Show this Friday. Lucinda, do your thing.
Not as good as Kurt's.
And over here, Lucinda, there we go.
Over here.
There we go.
When you're talking about, engine speed.
Yeah.
And you're talking about revs per minute.
Uh-huh.
There's a certain spin that she does that's, she just becomes a blur.
Wow.
But Lucinda is not only a great spinner, she's an artist with her work. It's like she's crafting something. She shapes her body into positions and shapes that other skaters just can't do.
I like the fact that she's wearing stripes.
And she's wearing stripes.
That looks good.
And the girl can wear horizontal stripes and make it look good.
Look at that. She's gone. Oh my god.
And so if we take the camera over there, you'll notice that she doesn't move at all. Like the whole spin happens within the size of a pie plate. And it's just absolutely amazing. And
you stopped on a dime.
And she doesn't fall over afterwards.
Now let's see how winded you are.
I'm sorry?
Are you dizzy? You can't understand me, can you? You're a little dizzy.
A little bit, but
I'll tell you about my car experience yesterday. That's it. Well, thank you for doing that. That's one of the things you'll see at the show this Friday. Kurt,
Friday at 8 o'clock at the arena.
And we're going to put you to the test later in the show.
I won't be spinning.
Okay. Ross, I could just do 8 or 7 donuts in the parking lot. That's all I can do.
Oh, I know. We've seen you at work before. That is amazing. And that she just kind of skates over to you there.
Yeah, that's right.
All right. Thank you, Mark. Time now is...
Mark Pitt is with one of the best skaters on the planet.
You know, and Frank, Kurt Browning, who I'm sitting next to, Kurt, you wanted to be a hockey player when you were like 15, but
Absolutely.
Then something happened. You didn't grow.
I forgot to grow a couple summers, and that was the end of hockey. I don't know, in Canada it's kind of a prerequisite. You play hockey or you get beat up or something. But figure skating was my calling. It's a way to do what you want to do and yet make people happy at the same time. It's an entertaining sport.
Excuse me, you like to watch hockey.
Oh, I love it. Yeah, I'm a big hockey fan. But, okay, just look at me. I never would have made it as a hockey player. And figure skating just gives you this chance to please people and yourself at the same time.
Do you appreciate the skaters in a hockey game, though?
Yeah, you and I were chatting about it. I went to a Toronto Maple Leafs game and I ended up watching the referee all night because he was this fantastic skater. He could spin, he could, do all these cool things. And I think that people live vicariously a little bit through an ice skater when they watch them. We build up speed and we look like we can fly and we have a lot of fun.
When we come back, we're going to put Kirk to the test because we picked some songs he's not used to, but he says he could improvise.
I don't even know what they are yet.
No, you're not. You're not going to do it. That's what's going to happen when we come back to Mornings on 2. Go practice. Go practice.
I'm going
to
go warm up.
Mornings on 2. Time is 7:54. I'm with Kurt Browning here for the Target Stars on Ice Show. We'll tell
Target
you where
Stars on Ice.
We're going to see it in a minute. Tell you where it is in a minute. Kurt, you are doing this show. You've done a lot of them.
Yep. This is my 7th year with Target Stars on Ice.
Big arenas. How do you play? How do you be intimate with the people in the back row? The people in the front row can see everything, but I'm at the back row.
I think you have to trust. I mean, when you have an audience that's like 18,000, sometimes we have 18,000 people, and you just you try. You go for these guys, mm-hmm. and if you, you know, if your emotions are big enough in the skating, but that's what skating does, is it's not all necessarily about the face. Mm-hmm. On TV it is. but in the real, it's about the motion in the body and what the body can do on the ice and the jumps and the spins and the choreography and all that good stuff.
Who do you have in this show coming up?
We've got Chris Yamaguchi, a Bay native.
Oh, yes.
And Ilya Kulik, the reigning Olympic champion for a couple more weeks. Stephen Cousins, all the girls want him. I don't know why. Okay. Anyways.
He's the younger guy with all the,
Katarina Witt, who's Playboy Bunny, all that good stuff.
She's for the guys.
Tara Lipinski, reigning Olympic champion. It's called Stars and Ice for a reason. So
it's
Target
an
put together
excellent
a good
group. Show. But we understand that you can improvise to songs. You do a lot of pop dancing to pop songs.
Aye.
You do. And you do a Casablanca thing. But we've picked some music for you that you're going to improvise to.
And if I look nervous, it's because I am. You know, and when you come to the show on Friday, which I hope you do, I'm going to know what I'm doing that night, but now I'm nervous. So what are you going
to
give me?
People at home right now are watching you as you normally do it. We're going to give that to them.
Okay.
Now we're
going to
see you with our music. We picked three songs. We'll talk in between.
All
right. You can do whatever you want. Whatever you want. Go
okay,
out there.
So as you're eating your Cheerios, please be patient.
Okay.
I don't know what's going to happen.
Go out, here it is. Go out there.
Oh, what is that?
That's Pink. I know that's a little hip-hop thing we got going there. Let's see how Kurt does. He is playing in the back row. It looks like Lucinda has joined.
There's a sub in. Lucinda, hey. She does all my spinning. When it's your seventh year of Stars and Ice.
Okay, we started easy because it was a hip-hop thing. Okay, here's the next one.
Okay, what is that? What was that? That was hip-hop?
That was Pink hip-hop. And
okay, so I'm going to go up to the next one.
We're going to go to the 50s now for this one. Here we go.
For the show, you get ready now. Go, Pat, go, but don't you step on my blue suede shoe.
Little Elvis Presley for you.
Well, you can do anything, but take me over my blue suede shoe.
Hey, that is good. Very nice. Okay. Elvis never did that. Hey, you're making me walk out there.
Can you help me?
I don't have skates on. I have wankles. All right. The last one has to do with the person you probably know. I'll give you a second to take a breath.
All right.
You know this person by name and by skating, and it's a song about him. Take it away. Yes, ladies and gentlemen, it's the South Park Brian Boitano song.
What would Brian Boitano do if he was here right now? He'd make a plan and follow through. That's what Brian Boitano do. When Brian Boitano was in the Olympics skating for the gold, he did two sal cows and a triple lunge while wearing a blindfold. When Brian Boitano was in the Alps fighting grizzly bears, he used his magical fire breath and saved the baby.
All right.
Fantastic.
You won't see that at the show.
That was my Brian Boitano impersonation.
Well, if you want to see Talking Stars on Ice, it is this Friday at the arena in Oakland. Number to call 510. Keep it flying. I love that. 762-2277. Then at the Compact Center in San Jose at Sunday at 4, and that's 408-998-TIX.
StarsandIce.com, Ticketmaster.com.
That was the best one. Keep going. Dance to that some more. I love that. We'll have more mornings on 2 after this. What would Brian Boitano do?